Calvin Casta and Rouse's Point Civic Center. It's the 17th day of February 2018, and we're here for high school hockey featuring the Northeastern Clinton Central School Cougars. And today's opponents from St. Lawrence County, the Norwood-Norfolk Flyers. And it's senior night here with the posters on the wall. It looks like there's a dozen seniors for the Cougars, so we're looking ahead to a long senior night adventure here as hockey game gets underway. A 3 o'clock start here on a Saturday afternoon, and last game before the playoffs begin. It looks like they're breaking in a new guy on the Zamboni. I think he needs a few more practice runs before he's ready for prime time. Senior added to Hannah Gordon, the manager. Twin sister of Ian is also going to be out there.
Oh my gosh.
Another dozen. We're going to be here a while shooting this. Escorting Julie Martin-Rao out there, I believe. I think that's, without seeing who it is, I'm guessing that's who it is. She's the official photographer. There we go, that's Julie. Even got her own little place to stand there. That would be removed before the game starts. I wish we could hear the PA, but that isn't possible in this place. Looks like Duffy will be number one. Yeah, they got Alfie LaRue just pointed out. More seniors than the Northern Norfolk has players today. I guess the reading that each of the parents had to say about their kid in the official program, there's a letter from each of the parents. There's a group photo of the 12 seniors, and Alfie LaRue was just saying that Northeastern had more seniors than Norwood-Norfolk has players here. Norwood-Norfolk almost canceled out. They're low on numbers. And weren't sure they could make it, but Cougars put a lot of extra emphasis on trying to get them here because of the importance of having the senior night event. Again, it would help if we had a speaker that we could hear, but Frank's only been here for 30 years, so they haven't quite figured out how to make the sound universal on the voice. Riley Duffy, number four, will be first. The booming young in America, so I'm going to be in in trouble here. Once I get a few numbers in, I'll be able to figure out who's who. Because they got a list on the board. Right now that board is being blocked. Maybe just Duffy's name is being blocked. Where'd he go? There we go. Next is number five of the Lady Lombard. There's Duffy over in Parents Row here. There's the Lombard. Where'd he go? They're kind of losing when he disappears along this line. I got Ian Gordon. His sister Hannah's still there, so maybe she'll come after him and maybe they come through at the same time. Hannah Gordon, team manager. That one, she was warming up with the team, a darn good skater too. Coming through, then next is Adam Gucci, who's making his way through. Does she have a number, or is she? Maybe number 23, I guess. Gucci, I guess he's skipping the teammates there. Well, next would be, wait, no, five, that was the Lombard coming through, and that was Gucci. Gucci number eight, so the Lombard just came back through. Now we got Duffy coming back through, so there's Gucci. So one of his teammates. Then we got Alex Richard. And his father Eric will be handling the mic for us for a little while here. He's got a youth game to all go to too. So. Barely getting done here, and then Bailey Lombard. Bradley LaFountain was that second guy. Not all I saw was the B and the L. I forgot that was Brad LaFountain, the coach's son. Oh my gosh, so embarrassed. Especially since his grandparents, the Dawsons, are here. They're gonna give me heck for messing up their grandson's name here. Number five, there he is. It's LaFountain. This is Lombard. Let's see, all I saw was the B and the L, and that must be Lombard. Now there's Lombard. He gets introduced twice on Hometown Cable. Isn't he lucky? And it's Brady. It's Brady LaFountain, not Bradley, too. Brady LaFountain. I'll teach him not to give me a sheet with the names on it. I'll teach him. Leave me on my own to try to figure all this out. Brady LaFountain. I'll zoom in and call him his right name this time. Brady LaFountain. Not Bradley. Not Billy Lombard. Next is Nick Rao. Where's Nick Rao go? Nick Rao is number 12. I don't see number 12. Is that 12? Did Ralph sneak through on me? Here. I don't know how 12 got a hold of 11. There's Noah Dupuy right there. Noah Doopy. And 12 is there. And we got Rao. Where's Rao? Rao coming through. Now we got 21 now. Evan Wager. Did we get Noah Doopy? I think so. Kyle Vassar, 25. We're getting to the end here, so I won't mess up too many more. Kyle Vassar. More and more flowers out to the... Everyone wants to bring flowers to the stands here. Now we got Anthony Byfong, Tony Byfong, one of the goalies. Tony Byfong, and now we got Nick Ledoux. His father is a viewer supporter of Hometown Cable, Alfie. Through parents' row here again, because unfortunately I didn't really see much here with the parents all stuck in there. Looks like it's it. Senior night here at Northeastern Clinton. Up next will be the introduction of the lineups. They're coming out of the stands. Aunt Amy is getting a flower.
February 17th. Iceman. Cougars sending a puck in deep. Giving chase, Brady LaFountain centering pass and over and score. 10 seconds and the Cougars are lighting the lamp. Going out strong on senior night. Ian Gordon, the centering pass from Brady LaFountain, and the Cougars are on the board. Puck drawn in, sent in by Iceman, played by goaltender Barkholm, up to Vassar. Iceman having a short bench, making the trip here. We appreciate them coming to town and being the opponent on senior night. Cougars strong with 11 seniors, 12 seniors, the Dirty Dozen,
Hannah.
Yes. Up to Bedard into the neutral zone, sent down. 15 for Norwood, giving chase, comes out strong behind his net, flipping it up in the neutral. Dupuy there to glove it down, sent back off the boards, down deep. 13 back to retrieve it, sending it up the boards, Bedard, a freshman, there to send it back. Coulomb giving chase, and we have an icing on the call. Referees today, we have Young Pichet, Rao out, take the draw with Duffy on defense. Giving chase in the corner, puck sent around. Gordon now in the corner, leaves it there for Rao. Iceman get pickpocketed by Rao. Little hip off on 23. Duffy keeps it in, sent to the corner. LaFountain there to play it. LaFountain picks it off up to Duffy. Sent to the corner, Rao retrieving. Guerin steps up to the blue line. LaFountain in the corner, centering to Rao. Rao just missing the net. Back to the point. Sent over to Guerin. Gains a red to LaFountain. Centering. Number 6 Iceman comes out. Sending it all the way down, no icing. Lombard back, Gallucci back, sent back up the boards. Noah Gagno, freshman, picks it up to Vassar, sending it in deep. Giving chase, Richard and Gagno, back behind the net is Vassar, chipped around, number 18, and sent down, and we'll have an icing call. 12:36 remaining in the first period. Cougars with an early 10-second lead, come out 1-0. Number 18, pucking his skates with Bellucci, flipped up and out of the zone. Lombard back. Number 8, Moulton giving chase. In by 22 of the Iceman. Bellucci there to play the puck. Up to boards to Vassar. Vassar picks it. Over to Gagno. Gagno with a shot just missing the net. Steered off wide as it deflected off the Norwood defenseman. Back and sent in by the Cougars. No icing. Barkholm out to play the puck. Another freshman, Jack Bolson, out to play it up, centering up to Raymond Miller. Wagger, our big defenseman, number 21. He's new to the team this year. a good fit. Seems to play hard every game. Cleared the zone by the Iceman, sent back in. Iceman send it down, and icing's your call. Face off, back in the Iceman zone. Cougars with a line change, with Noah Duke, Ian Gordon, Brady LaFountain, Nick Rao, and Landon Kulo. Up to the Iceman's corner, LaFountain there to retrieve it, centering attempt. Iceman come out with it one-handed. Doopy was there to break it up. Puck comes down low. And we had number 15 of the Iceman forechecking. That's Robert Voss doing a great job forechecking and working it in deep. Iceman go for a line change. Cougars draw the puck back. Number 23 for the Iceman. Giving chase, Poulon slaps it out of the zone. All the way down off a Norwood player. Centering attempt by Gordon. Back to the point. Shot in. A pad save by the goaltender. Duffy now sends it deep. Into the pads. Back to Duffy. Another shot in. Puck in the neutral. Number 18 now coming down. Coulomb swats it away from him. Rao in the corner. Comes up the middle to Gordon. Gordon at center ice. Rao. Picking up the puck, LaFountain, shot, and a goal. Second goal of the game, Rao, LaFountain from Rao at 10:14, remaining in the first period. A nice look at the net and a nice goal by LaFountain. LaFountain puck in the Iceman's zone. 15 giving chase. That's Voss again. Voss, very energetic player, working hard. Coming down the ice. Richard in his zone, off the boards. Gets to the neutral zone. Around the corner. Picked off. Pass gets picked off as they come up again. Voss gains the blue. Voss with some moves. Voss, no call on the play. They worked him hard. They kind of squeezed in on him. It's a good play. Nothing illegal. It's just hard work. They weren't going to let him get through and get a goal. Richard gains the red and sends it in. Cougars go for a line change. Miller's out with Bedard. Gallucci and Bombard on defense. We got a hooking on the Iceman, and the Iceman are going to be shorthanded. Cougar power play with 9:07 remaining in the first. Not what you really want to see in this game. You know, it's good to get a good competitive game and everybody play strong and play hard. Seems the Cougars have an advantage on the Iceman. And, you know, the short bench is going to have its effect on the Iceman. They're going to get tired. But Cougars with a large bench and mature bench. So penalties will prove to be LaFountain in the corner. LaFountain. LaVombard now keeps the puck in. Sends it in deep around the back of the net to Rao. Rao plays the edges. Comes back to LaFountain at the point. To Rao. Around the back of the net. Gallucci down low. Gallucci. Puck's forced into the middle. Gordon there to retrieve it and send it back down low. Rao. Back to the point. LaBombard. LaBombard getting a good shot off. Didn't quite get all of that. You kind of cringe when he takes his shot. It's got so much power. Gordon Nice look, nice look. Moves the puck to the far side. Now, puck gets deflected as Lombard shoots back to the point. Fountain, nice shot around the ice. Most of your goals are scored there. Sent out, Iceman. Gordon there to keep the puck in. 10 seconds remaining in the power play. Iceman's doing a good job boxing out, keeping the Cougars wide. Puck in the middle, chipped up. It's held in by the Lombard and fired back out. Penalty expires and we're going to have an icing call. Good penalty kill by the Iceman. I have to give him a hand on that. And the Cougars worked it around, had many opportunities. Now we have the Millers with Bedard and Olson. Iceman off the boards. Iceman have a break. Number two gets a shot on net. 23, back to the point. Voss, nice low shot, just wide of the net. Iceman putting on some pressure here. We get played around. Nice shot, right there it is. Iceman at the edge of the goal, and Iceman, Cougars are able to hang on, keeping that puck out. Great opportunity for the Iceman. Markholm shut him down. Buck back. Iceman steering Richard off. Richard there. Coulomb steps in. And we have a stoppage of play. Not certain what took place.
I'm not sure the clock was running. I think the last time I looked at it was 6:50.
Number 23 for the Iceman, Green. Joey Green wins the drawback. Hits, then the player gets hit by the puck. Coulomb. Coulomb taking a look. Flips it. Richard. Just two whacks at it. Oh. Coulomb off the boards and out. Number 9 Phillips back to his point man, point to point. Gagneau at middle ice. Iceman step up. Here we go, Voss breaks his zone. Voss, a quick shot into the pads of Guerin. Guerin not letting his goalie see the shots. That's key. They cannot score if they do not get a shot. So they limit your shots. Oh, Guerin off the bar, top bar and in. Shot from the slot. Ethan Guerin with a nice shot. Very quick, just under the bar. And Cougars have a 3-0 lead with 5:51 remaining in the first. Rao wins the draw back to Gucci. Gucci gains red line and sends it in deep. Behind the net, Iceman, number 13, clears it up the board. Gucci there to hold the puck in. Two Icemen, round now, low in the corner. Puck's tied up and sent all the way down. No icing to call. Barkholm out to play it. Sends it up and around. Up to Gordon. Gordon takes a look, gets it, chips it up to the center. Rao with the puck. Shot just wide of the net. Puck comes all the way back around. Le Bombard coming on for a new change. Sends it up to Gordon. Iceman's number 13 retrieves it, D to D. Number 11 for the Iceman, back over to 13. Stepping in. Defenseman joining the play on the rush. The Fountain crossing the puck over to Miller. Iceman cleared the puck, and we're going to have an icing call. Wagger, that play is stepping up and joining the rush. .434, Miller, Bard, and then we have Sam. Iceman gained the neutral. Barkle out to play it. Number 14 for the Iceman, centering attempt. Over. Miller now. Zach Miller. Back to Wagger. Shot and a goal. Wagger with a goal on senior night. Offsides, I believe me. May be the call. The goal may be waved off as we had a delayed offsides. But Wagger got a shot in Sam Bolson with the Millers. Miller and Gagneau. Miller's at the red, at the blue. Sent in by Jack, over to Miller. Jack Bolson, Sam Bolson. Sam Bolson in the corner, behind the net, and we have a whistle. And it looks like the faceoff's coming down to the Cougar zone. Jack Bolson, Landon Coulomb on defense with Noah Gagneau, Vassar and Richard. Puck going back, Coulomb sends it around. Gagneau there to pick it up, a nice breakout. Starting over to Richard, Richard at the blue. Shot deflected off the Iceman defenseman, an hour play. 3:35 remaining in the first period. Vassar doing chase in the corner, brings it out. Vassar with really good hands, gets back. Duffy, puck squeaks out, and offsides is your call. Richard, Gagneau, Vassar with Guerin and Duffy on defense, facing off. McCall on wing for Iceman, and Phillips at center. Puck back into the Iceman zone. Gagneau. And the puck again goes out of play. Offensive line change for the Cougars. Gordon, Rao, and LaFountain stepping on. Phillips and Rao facing off. Puck to the edge, LaFountain back to Guerin. Quick shot, saved by the Iceman. Goaltender, doing a nice job. Duffy, shot gets blocked. And here we go, I believe Vosk in here at 15. Sends it behind Guerin, up to LaFountain, to Gordon. And we have a whistle on the play, I believe it was offsides. Rao, Gordon, LaFountain going wide. Play is to draw it back to the defenseman and send it wide over to LaFountain. I've seen it work a couple of times. One back by the Iceman. Off the boards. The Fountain sends it in deep. A little dump and chase. Anytime you're going to do a dump and chase, you got to have somebody really aggressive on the forecheck. Rao. Down low. The Fountain. Centering attempt. Bellucci sends it in. Puck in front of the net. Iceman in the corner to retrieve. Gordon all over him. Takes the body. Iceman, the Fountain now behind the net. Iceman tying it up along the boards. And over. The Fountain giving chase. On the ice, Gallucci. Puck pops out. Iceman coming down. Gordon back. Break up the play. Gordon now going on the attack. A little wrist shot. Pad saved by the goaltender. Warner sending it in. Millers. Bedard sent in. Iceman now break their blue. Coming up, send it in deep. Barcombe steers it to the corner to Coulomb. Warner sends it up. Bedard. Iceman. Centering attempt. Coulomb. Right there. Phillips giving chase on Coulomb for the Iceman. Off the glass and out. Smart play bunking off that glass. Puck all the way down. Icing is going to be a call. 51 seconds remaining in the first period. Cougars with a 3-0 lead against the Norwood Icemen. Duffy and Jack Molson on the point. Quick shot by Richard out the faceoff. Gagneau in the corner sends it off. Duffy now. Duffy, puck just right of the net. Gordon, or Gagneau sending it low. Vassar down low. Vassar coming out with it and scores. Vassar coming off that goal line, stepping out a few feet and putting it off the inside of the post. Nice shot by Kyle Vassar. And Cougars with a 4-0 lead with 31 seconds remaining in the first. Phillips and Richard puck back to the Iceman zone. Duffy sent up to Bolson. To Gagneau, sent in deep. Vassar there to retrieve it. Iceman now break the zone. Bolson breaks up the play. Off the boards to Vassar. 8 seconds remaining. Iceman break up the play. And that will end the first period. 4-0 your score. Northeastern Clinton Cougars over Norwood Iceman. February 17th, 2018, senior night at the Rosses Point Rec Center. Second period action. Norwood Iceman, North Country Cougars, or NCCS Cougars, send it in. Gordon, Iceman off the boards, breaking the zone. Bellucci chips it over. LeBombard off the Iceman. LeFountain gaining the blue, working his opponent. Gordon behind the net. Thoreau. Back to LeBombard. Thoreau. Chipped up. Bellucci gloves it. Sends it to LeFountain in the center, and Rao picking up the rebound after Gordon's shot, and Cougars on the board at 34 seconds into the second period.
Slipping only took 10 in the first period.
Yes. Three times as long.
Yeah.
Facing off. Iceman. Puck in the Cougar zone. 14 for the Iceman. With Jack Bolson. Around comes Gagneau. The Vassar breaking the zone. Vassar at the blue. Richard sends it in, chips it in. Iceman now clearing the zone. Bolson sends it back. 15 for the Iceman. Holt, I believe, again. Here we go. Vassar, play busted up. Richard sends it in. Line change. Iceman D to D, up the middle. Icing going to be a call. 13-25, 5-0. Northeastern Clinton Cougars with a lead over Norwood Iceman. Millers and Bedard on the forward with Duffy and Kulo. Sent over. Oh, Miller with a quick shot. Miller to Miller. And a shot. Held on by Iceman's goaltender. Wagstaff. Steven Wagstaff. Puck up. Chipped up by Phillips. Off the boards. Number 18. Fanned on by number 8. Miller now coming up. A little too close to his opponent. Miller gets another chance at it. Wagstaff steers it. Bedard behind the goal to Miller. Miller to the point to Duffy. Duffy, quick snapper. Miller giving chase. Off the glass and out. Phillips gains the blue. Broken up by Bedard. Coulomb sends it around to Duffy. Duffy back to Coulomb. Up the middle, Bedard. Miller sends in deep. Off the glove of Wagstaff. Miller. Around the back. Broken up by Luzon. Jude Luzon. Norwood. Lombard stepping on the ice. Norwood gains the blue in the corner. Cougar is going to have a penalty. As I believe LaFountain goes to the box for slashing. Or Guerin, excuse me. That's Ethan Guerin, another tall player. And LaFountain to the bench. That's Gordon, LeBombard, Rao, and Gallucci on a penalty kill. Back to the point. Cleared. Oh, held in by the Iceman. Gordon, good box by the Cougars. They managed to get a far post, but blocked by LeBombard. Puck comes up, Gordon, now Rao, shorthanded opportunity. Rao with a shorthanded goal. Nick Rao with a good effort. Getting past his opponent, outworking him, and scoring a beautiful backhander goal. The sixth goal of the game, Nick Rao at 11:24. Richard Vassar-Gagneau pushed in. Moss behind his net. Back up. Iceman come up the middle. Phillips, far side, Voss not making the blue line. Well by Richard, swatted out of the zone. Voss, quick shot, a glove by Anthony. Iceman send it in deep. Miller chips it up. Iceman with a penalty. 4-on-4. Play for 22 seconds and the Cougars will be on a power play. Lucas Bedard on the draw. McPhillips back to the corner. Boss sends it around. Down low, Miller reaching. Miller sends it behind the net. Bedard quick to get there. Sends it back. Jude up the middle. Phillips, D to D, Wagger. In the middle, Wagger comes out. Boss, Bedard, and Miller to Sam Bolson. Centering pass. And we're gonna have another penalty. As Cougars Bedard taken to the box and an interference call. Good play by the freshman Sam Bolson in the corner. Stick with it and center the pass as he took a good body check. But made the pass to the middle. Good scoring attempt by the freshman. Fountain now facing off with Duffy. Coulomb. Puck out to 13, who sends it back and around. Coulomb. Phillips down low with Coulomb. Coulomb. Up the middle. Puck down in the Iceman zone for an icing call. Play goes back to the Cougar zone. Four-on-four action. Duffy behind the net to Gagneau. Gagneau, the freshman, coming up in his feet, steers it in to Voth. Voth, D to D. Sent in deep. Phillips giving chase on Duffy. Duffy sends it over to the fountain. Cross ice, Gagneau backhanding it. Up the middle, Coulomb picks the play apart. Iceman with Rao back checking. Phillips in the corner with Rao on him quickly. Rao with the speed, gets tripped and gets back up. Delayed penalty call, sent in deep. Gordon now back to the point, to Gallucci, to Gordon. LaFallon behind the net and the Iceman tag up. 6-0 your score, 8:42 remaining. I hand you off to Calvin Kastein.
Thank you, Eric. I know you've got the more hockey to worry about, so you can take that with you. I got one in my back pocket.
Thank you.
All right.
Eric Richard, heading off to do some hockey with younger children, and also does a great job on the microphone. Unfortunately, as we said, the program does not have a Cougar roster in it. It's all, it's one thing I always depend on. I know I show up here and the Cougar's going to have a roster with all the names on it, so I don't have to worry about it. Unfortunately, all they had was the seniors, all the photos, nice brochure put together. As a supplement, they had the Norwood-Norfolk flyers, the Iceman flyers. It says Iceman on the shirt. I know the school name is Flyers, but Iceman may prefer to be called Iceman, which is fine with me. So we have the visitors roster, but we don't have the home team roster. And we've lost the man with all the knowledge. It snuck in there by Richard. I hope Eric was able to see that as his son Alex scores to put the Cougars up by a 7-0 margin with 7:52 showing here in the second period. It was a power play goal, so the penalty is erased. Remaining time is erased. We'll go 5-on-5. This is President's Day weekend, Saturday. Cougars had a game against Lake Placid last week that was canceled. And this Saturday game was almost canceled, but the Norfolk team decided they could come, even though they're very, very short-handed. Very important for the Cougars to get their senior night thing done here in their last home game. As long as the seniors score, then I'll be able to tell you who scored by Steve Bennett. There in Riley Ford territory. .556 on the clock here in the second. 30 degrees and shut our vehicle off. fairly long period. We've still got 5:36 to go. I've got 16 and a half minutes recorded. Usually 21, 22 minutes is what it takes to record a period. This one here is going to be 24, 25. Score. But the Flyers got one behind the roller. Yep, 8-1, the scoreboard says. Shoreville number 13 who did it. Team got the assist and get the number of the score. Between periods we'll read off the Flyer names, or the Weissman names. Defense. That's the blue. Three and a half left in the second period. Not sure why the play was blown dead. Doesn't seem like the puck was tied up. Oh, penalty, that's why. New Flyer in the box, so it's going to be another Cougar power play, just what they need with an 8-1 lead, with another power play. It's like Richard will take the draw. Icing. There for the Flyers. 23 seconds to go in the penalty. many stick is it near mid-ice and along the boards. Minute 36 left in the second period. I'm going to be able to get that stick off the ice. And another penalty on Norwood-Norfolk. Reminder, this is viewer-supported local television. We appreciate Hometown Cable being here on a chilly February afternoon on a Saturday. We need to hear from you. We continue doing this. We absolutely, positively need viewer support. We have some support from the Cougar hockey family, but certainly the vast majority do not support us, and of course our latest one today is Alfie Ledoux joining the ranks of viewer supporters. We appreciate that. And our others, including our play-by-play man, Eric Mitchell, a great supporter of Hometown Cable. 54 to go on the penalty, 40.5 to go in the period. Seconds in the period. Gordon, I believe. Yeah, Ian Gordon. He's at 9-1 with 7.2 remaining in the period. Gordon found the back of the net. And the Cougars are all but certain to be in double figures in this game. Well, in period number two, Cougars leading 9-1 here on viewer supported local television. Phillips 9, Hayden Bullock 10, Connor Page 11, Cody Forbert is 12, Cade Van Buren is 13, Reed Gravlin is 14, Ledoux makes the stop, Robert Voss 15, Bodie Molnar 16, we'll zoom in. After we finish reading here, Ty Carter 17, John McCall, 18. Corey Rossum, 19. Drew Ashley, 21. Blake Richards, 22. Joey Green, 23. Thomas Caffarello, 30. Ben Averill doesn't have a number listed. Head coach is Doug Levine. Rick Short and Adam Cook are the assistants. And those are the Norwood-Norfolk Flyers. They have Iceman on their shirt. Outside first step, fella. And if this game is done in time, we'll finish, we'll get the end of it. If not, we may have to leave early. We got 5:30 Mass in St. Mary's in Champlain, and I'm not going to stick around for an extra 3 minutes of hockey. I'm going to have to go to Mass in the morning and make me late for the youth tournament games that I'm covering. We get a weekly obligation done tonight. Hopefully they turn this into a long third period. Already there are fans complaining that it's not quite as exciting as they hoped it would be with a 9-run score. Well, 2 minutes into the third period. And the goalie covers up. Sends that around the boards. We're level 3 minutes into the third period. Fan that's excited, all on the side of us. really want to acknowledge that despite being low on numbers, having a lot of kids out sick and injuries and whatever, Norwood-Norfolk came here and provided the Cougars with an opponent on their senior night. It was 21. Wager, I think. We'll try to pick up the PA if we can. No way I can hear, understand what they're saying. Four minutes into the third period, and we will leave early if we have to. It's 10-1 game, it's not like the winner is in doubt. It's a matter of what the final score will be. Excuse me, 5 minutes into it, 10 to go. Is in town. How about that? The fewer whistles we have, the better we like it. It's now approaching 5 p.m. But the pace off is going to come back here. Pull it left foot. What are we going to do? Looking at the game through the lens here. halfway through the third period. Stop by the news. I like it when it goes long stretches with that whistle there because of the icing. 6:11 left in the game. It's in. A goal for the Flyers. The Icemen have scored, and it's now 10-2 at 5 minutes and 47 seconds to go. Like it was number 9. Unfortunately, that list is in my pocket, and either hold the camera or grab the list, and then hold the camera. Only 15 scored, I don't know. Only 15 scored. I was watching the puck, not the shooter. Down to 5 minutes to go in the game. It's going to be close as to whether I can finish it. .48 left.
3 now. Done in 5 minutes, I'll stick around. If not, I'll be leaving. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Well, I'm gonna be on the Cougars. So it'll be a power play for the Icemen. Under 2 to go in the game, less than a minute and a penalty. Seconds in the penalty. I'm up with 27 to go in the penalty, 124 to go in the game. Let's go. This game moving. Five seconds. So, 18 to go, we're going to say, you've been watching viewer-supported local television hometown cable. We're coming at you from the Rouse's Point Civic Center, February 17th, 2018. Our thanks to those of you who understand about viewer support and support our efforts. And thank you for watching. We're out of here.